What's happening, YouTube? This is Matt the StarCraft, and I am here with a sweet game for you, which I can't wait. Two of my favorite players ever, and I am excited to bring this game to you between Dignitas Select and Eitri Idra, also known as the Gracken. Now, both these players, this game is actually coming from MLG Columbus. Both these players have extremely great records. They are great players, all of them. Recently, both were in the IGN Pro League Season 1 in April, and Idra took that game, took that series, from Kiwi Cocky, taking first place, Kiwi Cocky taking second. And what's interesting is that D-Select himself lost to Kiwi Cocky, taking third. So Kiwi Cocky got stuck in the middle, winning second place, D-Select winning third, losing to him, and Idra taking first, and therefore winning the entire tournament. Now, what's even better is that Dignitas Select and Idra both don't really have major wins under their belt. Dignitas Select primarily having only one first place, and I think it was the I-42 multiplay. I think I'm probably getting that somewhat wrong, but that was his only first place win. Nothing huge. He's got a lot of seconds, a lot of thirds. He is from South Korea, part of Team Dignitas, obviously. An extremely good Terran player, always someone to keep an eye on, and his day is coming. Mark my words, his day is coming where he's going to win something big. And same thing with Idra. He has not won anything huge. He has won a few smaller things. He did win the IGN Pro League. That is about one of the only things he's won. He did win MLG DC in 2010. He did take first place in that as well. This is from MLG Columbus. I'm not quite sure if I said that. So a little bit of back history for these two players. Both of them great, and I'm looking forward to seeing them clash. Idra did beat Select last time MLG DC as well. So very fun. I'm looking forward to watching this game. Idra, also known for his insane macro. He has a huge macro style of play. It's one of his most notable features, always trying to expand, take over the map as a good Zerg should, and Tal Dream Altar, which is the map we're on, is perfect for that. And any player should be trying at least a macro-oriented game. This is the MLG version of this map, so we'll see if that... I don't even know, honestly, what the difference is. I know some of them have neutral buildings placed on them in certain areas, but I'm not quite sure what the difference is in this one. If you guys could point that out, that would be awesome. I'm actually just kind of looking around, seeing what I can figure out, if anything. But he looks like he's gonna be grabbing his early hatchery. I wouldn't be surprised to see him go some sort of especially in against a Terran. He's known to go like Mutalisk Lings and Banelings. So it looks like we've got a one barracks, one factory open with a reactor. Maybe we'll see some heavy infantry more than likely, though, after he pops out a few Marines. We'll be seeing the factory and the barracks switch, and we'll probably see some Hellions drop on the field trying to keep Idra contained. And like I said, I wouldn't be surprised to see some heavy Zergling, Baneling, Mutalisk play from Idra himself. I'm very known to do that, especially against Terran players. So we'll see what happens there. I'm waiting for the day that Idra wins a huge tournament himself as well. Both these players are long overdue to win something major. You know, it's just something that they both are just great players. Idra playing in Korea for a very, very long time, playing for a Korean team. Also for Brood War, when he played Brood War, he played for two Korean teams. I can't remember the names of them, honestly. I didn't follow this Brood War scene all too much. And D-Select actually was a competitive Dawn of War player. That is one of his backgrounds, is Dawn of War. That's where he kind of comes from. And it looks like the scout's going to see a bunch, get everything he needs to know. We are going to have Spinecrawler dropping down. And we're going to have the 1-1-1 opening from D-Select himself. And it looks like he is popping out those Hellions right there. He does have this on the tech lab, and it looks like he's switching over. So some Banshee play early in the game, it looks like. So we'll see what happens there. The 1-1 opening, extremely solid and extremely common for 90% of the Terrans out there. If we take a look at the unit counting station here, Idra is ahead in the drone count with that one mule and 22 SCVs for its Select, and 28 drones for Idra. And we have eight Zerglings on the field as well, along with one Marine, four Hellions. And we do have that Banshee on the way, with two more Hellions on the way for Select. He's just kind of pulling the center. It looks like he did do a little bit of a push. I apologize, I missed that. He does have all of his Hellions, so probably just swung in. Did he kill any workers? No, he did not. So maybe he got a few, he got two units killed, so assuming Zerglings. That's about it. And we are dropping another Spinecrawler. Smart move, knowing there are Hellions on the field, catching that. He's just getting prepared, getting those static defenses so he can continue his macro. A lot of Zergs, professional Zergs, apparently do that, where they just drop a lot of static defenses so they can get their economy up and running and get that stable income. That way they can do what all Zergs are meant to do, is just make units en masse in reaction to whatever their opponent is making. We do have a Overlord scooting around the backside, has a super spy mission to head in the back and see what's going on. He'll probably poke in, see if he can see anything whatsoever. We do have another attack going on. The Queens and the Spinecrawler is going to ward that off. The Banshee barely making out with its life. Did it get anything? It looks like a few Zerglings. And that's about it. The Queens are very much alive. And we do have an Overseer going. Seeing that Banshee Overseer, smart move, just to be able to catch that cloak if cloak gets upgraded, which it is currently not, but still very useful to have, especially if you want to do some scouting with a Changeling. Might as well use that energy for something. And there's the Spire going down, so we will see some Mutalisk play. Heavy Ling, Baneling, I would not be surprised whatsoever. 2C, we have an Armory going down for Deselect here. So Thor play, has he seen this? Did he do a scan? Let's take a peek, see. Did he do a scan? No, he did not do a scan, so he's not aware. He's just preemptively assuming that's what's going to be happening. So interesting play. Kind of a blind build, but it's going to work out for him in the end, it looks like. And a Baneling Nest also dropping down for Idra. So yes, Ling Bling Muta is looking like what's going to happen. He is going to be, G-Select is going to be grabbing his expansion, getting his economy going, knowing he's a base behind. And when, should I say, Idra sees this, grabbing his third, even if he doesn't see it, he'll be grabbing his third on the 10-minute mark. Looks like we have another push. Even those Banshees for the high ground, those flames, for some reason, ignoring the Z-axis. Blizzard's game is notorious for ignoring the Z-axis completely. Are any of the Queens going to go down? No, using that Transfuse. And he's going to try to keep the Spinecrawler up as he tries to plant, knowing that he's going to be able to do extra damage to those Hellions, but they back those Hellions off, realizing he's not going to be able to do any more damage. Doing some damage to this, but not really doing anything other than damage. And again, if the building still persists at the end of your harassment, then ultimately you've accomplished nothing. Taking these rocks down, looks like he's getting ready to grab his third. I like this third placement. As I said, it's really short air distances, so sometimes you won't see that happen because this is so far. But his creep spread is really good, allowing those movements. The movement's going to be very, very easy to have his troops popping in and out. Now we do have this over here. Let's see what he's seen. He has popped in and seen that. So very smart on his end. We do have the Mutalisk popping out now. We have, as far as Mutalisks go, popping open that production. We have 7 with 2 more on the way. He is head and heels above Deselect as far as drones go. And now we got some Mutalisks swinging in here to do some of that harassment. Popping in, trying to take out, and he's going to see quickly that Thor's in, and he's going to scoot on out before the Thor can do anything but a quick little scratching to one of those Mutalisks. So smart move. And what is Deselect doing down here? Sneaky, sneaky Deselect grabbing a third base, but Idra has his Overlord down there, but he has not seen it, barely skipping by, missing that ever so much, and he's just going to kind of poke around. But did he see the SCV move over there? Maybe he already knows it's there, but we'll see how he reacts to that. Grabbing that third, and it looks like a drone, and they're pausing momentarily. And I'm assuming it gets paused. Yeah, there it is. There we go. Whoa, it seems only you. It was just complete pauses. Okay, ready, go. So something was going on at Idra's side. Grabbing his fourth, though, at the same time he's grabbing his third, so really looking to macro up. So I assume he already knows about that third base. Maybe he saw the SCV go over there. Completely one step ahead of the game, grabbing that fourth base, keeping one base ahead of his Terran opponent Deselect. So smart move on Idris' move. And these guys, I love Mutalisk. As I said, there is a fourth resource in this game, as Day 9 has so openly pointed out before, and it is map control. And early game, Zerglings give you huge map control, Hellions can give you huge map control. Mid game, Mutalisk. If you can get Mutalisk out as a Zerg, you get map control so well. You can swing him around, keep your enemy pinned in his base. Doing this pretty much tells Deselect here that he is going to have a hard time moving out without anything short of a couple of Thors, which he has here. But with those moving out, he's going to quickly face some sort of boxing in, and it's just going to really, really, really hurt him. And just kind of keep him stalled. But he does have that secret third up, but again, Idra is still one base ahead, fully aware, and this creep spread by Idra is actually really good. Slowly moving that creep around, keeping his Banelings and Zerglings on the creep to make sure they are able to do a quick surround. And is he going to poke in here, do any damage? Let's see. He is going to swing in. And yes, he's going to aim for that turret first, make sure it doesn't do any damage, but those Thors are right there. He's gonna quickly take out one of those targets, but at the loss of one of his Mutalisks, it's almost a second, so worth it in his eyes, perhaps, because now he's gonna have to rebuild that turret if he wants to make sure that it's safe, or sacrifice one of his Thors and put it at the edge of his base. Again, these Mutalisks keep him contained. Keep him contained and force him to build more Thors. And again, you see more Thors in the production tab up there. He is building more. An infestation pit going down for Idra as well. If we take a look, he is completely saturated in his natural. His main is almost, is still, you know, looking all right. He is getting mined out. I apologize, clear my throat on you. And we are getting Zergling. So this base doesn't have any, but he is doing a small transfer of drones here. But this one is looking pretty good. It's slowly getting there. He is dropping some static defenses because he knows it's going to be harder. And an auxiliary hatchery, which is smart, especially with the economy he has going and he can't keep up. And this helps actually create a very narrow choke right here, forcing the units to either be choked down and caught, which I wouldn't be surprised to see him move over those, like a spine crawler over here or something, just to make sure it's even more so. And he is popping in here. Is he going to do any damage at all? Let's take a look. He's going to get ready to swing in. There we go. He's going to cancel that tart right there to stop it, but all the other tarts are firing. He is forcing a lot of the economy on tart, trying to take out a bunch of drones, but he lost a few Mutalisks. Might not have been worth the harass that he just did. Going to swing those out of there and continue flying around, making sure no other secret bases go up, keeping him pinned. There is a fourth base going down now with a bunch of missile turrets for deselect, trying to keep ahead of the game in the economy, knowing that he has been pinned, needs to keep all of these up, missile turrets up, forcing a lot of his minerals and missile turrets can really hurt, especially when they're not being used on SCVs or units. So again, the Mutalisk, though he has good defenses up, and the Zergling is going to catch that. Though he doesn't have, isn't completely pinned, those Mutalisks do create a sense of fear. It is mind games on Idra's part while he continues to get his tech up. Pathogen gland's going down, so we'll see some infestors dropping, it looks like, along with hive tech, so especially the Ultralisks or Broodlords later in the game if he gets that far, unless one of the players pull out an earlier win. Though this game has been going on for 15 minutes thus far, and he is continuing to pump his Mutalisks here, and now he's going to swing in here with a bunch of Zerglings, knowing that those missile tarts aren't going to do much, but it is a planetary fortress, so Zerglings be very ineffective here, and my phone is ringing. I gotta make sure that when I'm casting, my phone is on like silent or something, because when it rings and I see it's my girlfriend, I don't really have much choice to answer, but I put it on silent, and then I ignore it, and I tell her that I, oh, it was on silent, I'm sorry, baby, I missed it. Then she can't really complain. So, plans for the future. But as you see, StarCraft has taught me strategy, and I am now strategizing how to keep casting StarCraft over ignoring my girlfriend. No, I'm just kidding, though. I love my girlfriend. I wouldn't ignore her. Don't yell at me, guys. God, calm down. I can see your faces already. Oh, God, he says StarCraft's more important than his girl. Maybe it's true for some people, but not for me. So, back to the game. I apologize. We do have four Festers on the way with level... Oh, is that two? Yeah, level two melee and Neural Parasite. So, ooh, very smart. Maybe he'll use those Infestors to mind control those Thors, knowing that they're going to be a problem with the Mutalisks and the Banelings, perhaps. And look at this. Oh, they're being friendly. He's grabbing an expansion. And right next door, he's grabbing especially like next door neighbors. Though they're probably like violent next door neighbors. So we'll see what happens. Maybe they'll get into it like the parents will get drunk and they'll start yelling at each other and throwing bottles through the window. And then they'll just get really upset. And I think my childhood is coming back to haunt me there. So I apologize. But we have a Zergling here. And here we go. We got a bunch of Mutalisks coming in to take out that turret again. But there come the just the Thors come out. He pocks out. So really just being annoying, dropping in a bunch. Just coming in with his Mutalisks, killing off a missile turret, flying out, forcing the Thor to be out of place, and then going back and doing about his business. So, currently, as far as the macro game and the economy is concerned, Idra is ahead. It is 200 and 200, so expect some sort of attack soon to at least clear up food if he wants to continue doing that or force some sort of a confrontation here. See what happens.